Raggedy Andy brought a small stew kettle, while the others brought the sugar and water and a large spoon. They could not find any vinegar and decided not to use it anyway. Raggedy Andy stood upon the stove and watched the candy, dipping into it every once in a while to see if it had cooked long enough, and stirring it with a large spoon. At last the candy began to string out from the spoon when it was held above the stew kettle, and after trying a few drops in a cup of cold water, Raggedy Andy pronounced it done. Uncle Clem pulled out a large platter from the pantry, and Raggedy Ann dipped her rag hand into the butter jar and buttered the platter. The candy, when it was poured into the platter, was a lovely golden color and smelled delicious to the dolls. Henny could not wait until it cooled, so he put one of his chamois skin hands into the hot candy. Of course, it did not burn Henny, but when he pulled his hand out again, it was covered with a great ball of candy, which strung out all over the kitchen floor and got upon his clothes. Then, too, the candy cooled quickly, and in a very short time, Henny's hand was encased in a hard ball of candy. Henny couldn't wiggle any of his fingers on that hand, and he was sorry he had been so hasty. While waiting for the candy to cool, Raggedy Andy said, "We must rub butter upon our hands before we pull the candy, or else it will stick to our hands, as it has done to Henny's hands, and have to wear off." "Will this hard ball of candy have to wear off my hand?" Henny asked. "It is so hard I cannot wiggle any of my fingers." "It will either have to wear off, or you will have to soak your hand in water for a long time, until the candy on it melts," said Raggedy Andy. "Dear me," said Henny. Uncle Clem brought the poker then, and asking Henny to put his hand upon the stove leg, he gave the hard candy a few sharp taps with the poker and chipped the candy from Henny's hand. "Thank you, Uncle Clem," Henny said as he wiggled his fingers. "That feels much better." Raggedy Andy told all the dolls to rub butter upon their hands. "The candy is getting cool enough to pull," he said. Then, when all the dolls had their hands nice and buttery, Raggedy Andy cut them each a nice piece of candy and showed them how to pull it. "Take it in one hand this way," he said, "and pull it with the other hand like this." When all the dolls were supplied with candy, they sat about and pulled it, watching it grow whiter and more silvery the longer they pulled. Then, when the taffy was real white, it began to grow harder and harder, so the smaller dolls could scarcely pull it anymore.